On the Banana River, a local fire department could only stand idly by and watch it burn. WestJet reporter Michelle Meredith is live in Cocoa Beach. And Michelle, why the troubles fighting this fire?
Well, basically because they don't have a fire boat. Well, this is the dock where the boat was tied up. As you can see, it scorched the dock, and then the boat drifted off into the Banana River where it is right now. And the boat certainly lived up to its name. Major Issues. Major Issues was a 40-foot, $300,000 fishing boat. But this morning, it went up in smoke, a blaze so spectacular that traffic on 520 came to a grinding halt. Firefighters say the owner planned to go fishing, turned on the generator, had a bite to eat at a restaurant just feet away, and when he returned, it was smoking.
There's a big old plume of black smoke coming up, and by the time I got down here to the bridge, it was all engulfed, already fully engulfed in flames, and you could barely see the boat for the smoke.
The fire burned the ropes holding the boat, so the dock and restaurant did not catch on fire. But the boat drifted out into the Banana River, making it difficult for the landbound Cocoa Beach Fire Department to reach.
Not so much to save the boat, but the boat was hauling 400 gallons of diesel fuel that, if we continued to let it burn, may have breached the tank and then ended up in the Banana River.
Why doesn't the Cocoa Beach Fire Department have a fire boat?
The simple answer for that's money. We average maybe one or two boat fires a year.
And fire boats cost anywhere from $50,000 to $100,000. For the record, the Coast Guard was here, but the Coast Guard does not put out fires. And because the boat has 400 gallons of diesel, they're waiting for trained professionals to move it carefully. Live in Brevard County, Michelle Meredith.